Three ways to accelerate your pandas code today using NVIDIA's GPUs. Number one, we add a magic command to the top of your notebook. This works right now within Google Colab and Kaggle notebooks. Number two, we just add a module flag within your Python execution statement. This works in the command line or within your IDE run and debug settings. And number three, just a couple of lines of CUDA-F code at the top of your current and future code. Two of the methods don't require any code change. Let's quickly go over how to use each of them. I've got 4 years of NFL data and three lines of code to help me prepare for my fantasy football draft, but really we're just doing some basic summary statistics analysis. So again, I've got 4 years of NFL play-by-play data from 2020 to 2024 in this Parquet file. And then I have this Google Colab notebook. I have an L4 GPU. Now, if you don't know how to do that, you click change runtime type on this little triangle. And then you can choose which runtime type you want. The T4 is free. I'm using a pro version of Google Colab, so I have an L4. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and run this data and then show you what the three lines of code do. So the first line of code is going to read that Parquet and load it into a pandas data frame. I copied that data over from my Google Drive. The second line of code here is, quote unquote, quantizing, where it's going to take floats and convert them to ints if possible, but it's also going to take my strings and object types and convert those to floats and ints if possible. This is just to help speed things up. And then finally, the third line of code here is I'm going to group all of my play-by-play data by game, home team, away team, season type, playoffs, regular season, and then the week, and then the possession team. So this is going to group all of that, flatten all that data by essentially the possession team and the play-by-play data. And then I'm going to get the sum and the mean of the yards, rushing yards, passing yards. And then we're going to, of course, time that. That took 31.42 seconds. Now, I'm not going to change any of this code, but I am going to make use of that GPUs by doing this magic command load ext cudef. Pandas, and if I can type pandas. Now, CUDA-F stands for NVIDIA CUDA, which is our GPU acceleration library. And on top of that, we have this data frame library that accelerates pandas, but also Spark and Polars. In this case, we're using the CUDA-F.pandas magic command here. Now, before I run this, notice when I displayed the alias for the Python library, it is what you expect. It points to where that library is installed. But this time, now that I've run this CUDA-F pandas magic command before the import, I'm going to see this proxy type for pandas here. And this means I'm going to run the pandas code on the GPU. If we don't have it implemented or it's not parallelizable, it's going to gracefully run it on the CPU and then go back to the GPU. All right, so last time I ran that took 31.42 seconds, these three lines of code. This time it's going to take 0.79 seconds. So that is a speed up of almost 40 times. So 40 times faster. If I'm in a hurry getting ready for my fantasy football draft and I just need to run three lines of code, a half minute's gonna seem like an eon. Less than a second won't be noticeable. Again, I have my stats here. Everything looks fine and dandy. And so that is speeding up your pandas code in a Google Colab notebook. This also works in Kaggle notebooks and also in your local notebooks. All right, so I have the same code from our notebook in a Python script file here. I'm going to load that play-by-play data, get the most efficient data types for each column, and then run my summary statistics, and I'm going to time the whole thing. All right, whoops. So I have a very powerful machine here. I have 32 cores or virtual cores, and then I also have, I'm spec'd for, 64 gig of RAM, okay? So this is no slouch of a machine. All right, if I run this file here, this script here, this is gonna take a little over 10 seconds, so very fast machine here. Now, 10 seconds, if you're in a hurry and you're doing this over and over and over again, 10 seconds starts to feel like a lot. All right, 11 seconds. Now, I don't want to wait all that time. I have a GPU. I have an NVIDIA GPU. I want to take advantage of it. So I'm going to go over to rapids.ai. I'm going to click install. And we have this little tool here, okay? I need to know which version of CUDA I'm running, so I'll do NVIDIA SMI. You can see I have this really nice 86,000 GeForce GPU, and I have CUDA version 12.4, so I know to leave that there. I can do pip, conda, docker, gonna go with stable, and then you can choose your specific library. Since we're doing pandas here, CUDAF, short for, again, NVIDIA CUDA for data frame, speeds up pandas, polar, spark. We also have CUML or CUDA for machine learning, will speed up scikit-learn. And then we also have, you know, cuGraph for network X, cuVS for vector search, which speeds up vector databases. I'm just gonna do CUDAF here. And this is gonna give me the command. No matter which package, you know, method you use, it's gonna give you the command or the Docker, you know, command to download that container and run it. Let me go back to CUDAF here. All right, so I'm gonna copy that command, bring it back to my command line, and run this pip install, right? And the package is CUDAF CU12 for CUDA version 12. This is the latest stable version, and it's gonna get it from our PyPI webpage here. I've already installed it, so this should be really fast. All right, so just as a reference, I'm gonna run this command just like I did before. It took 11 seconds. I'll speed up the video here. Okay, so I'm not gonna change any code. I'm just gonna do module CUDAF pandas and run this, and let's see here. That is about a half a second, a little over half a second. So we'll get the exact difference here, 11.44, 0.59. So that is almost a 20 times speed up. I didn't change any code. I just ran that pip install and added this module. When you're running in VS Code or PyCharm or whatever IDE, you can add this to your run and debug configuration to speed up that code or speed up that debugging. I think this is really cool. All right, so 4 years of play-by-play NFL data in this Parquet file, 3 lines of code to summarize it. And so you can see I've displayed the alias as expected, pointing to the, you know, where the directory where that file is installed. And now these 3 lines of code, I'm gonna load that play-by-play Parquet file into a pandas data frame. I'm going to get the most, you know, efficient types, floats, ints if possible, strings, objects to floats and ints if possible. And then I'm going to summarize total yards, rushing yards, and passing yards, the sum and the mean of each by team per week. All right, that took 31.47 seconds. Now, I didn't use the NVIDIA L4 GPU, but I can do a magic command, or I can do this import CUDAF pandas, and then CUDAF pandas install. And before, when we displayed the alias for the pandas import library here, this time we're going to see that proxy type. So this is, again, we're going to run that code in the GPU, the pandas code in the GPU, gracefully fall back to the CPU when needed, and then go back to the GPU. This time around, that same code, those 3 lines of code, took 0.84 seconds. That is a speed up of 37 times. All right, so again, if I'm preparing for my fantasy football draft, and I'm, you know, maybe I'm even on the clock, and a half a minute's gonna feel like an eon. Less than a second won't be noticeable, but I'll have my stats right at my fingertips as I'm, you know, preparing for my draft, so to speak, or whatever analysis you seem to be working on. Just to recap, you can accelerate your pandas code right now by adding a magic command to the top of your notebook, injecting a module flag within your Python execution statement, or adding a couple lines of CUDAF code at the top of your code. All three of these methods will accelerate your pandas code on NVIDIA GPUs. In addition to pandas, we also accelerate Polars, Spark, XGBoost, scikit-learn, NetworkX, again, all open source on GitHub. So we'd love you to drop us a comment, point out an issue, drop us a feature request, or even contribute to the project, we'd love to hear from you. As always, cheers and happy coding.